Hey everyone, Chloe here and welcome back to my channel. And if you are new here, ladies and lurkers and ear hustlers, welcome. So I wanted to make a video to unpack and to share some of my observations on the current reality TV messiness that is Miss Porsha Williams and her now fiance and serial husband, Mr. Simon Guabadia. Now there has been a lot of social media chatter and there are now a lot of Simon Says side chicks who are also speaking their piece about Mr. Simon's character, but I also know enough about womanhood to spot a desperate woman who wants to be rescued and who was in the thick of and in the midst of some very poor decision-making when I see one. And I will be breaking down this desperado behavior later on in the video. But just as a reminder to those of you who are tuning in, before I begin, that this is Porsha's life and that our opinions do not pay her bills and that her life is her messy mistake to make as it is her agency to live her life as happy and or as foul or as desperate as she wants to live it. And if Porsha Pusheisty is allowing the dark shadow of her Delilah spirit to send her right over a Mount Everest cliff, then it is well within her right to do so. But in life, as with everything, all actions or inactions come with consequences. Some of those consequences are unwanted, some are predictable, and some you will never see coming. And in life, sometimes a woman will need to be skull-dragged to learn life's most powerful lessons. Now, for those of you who have been living under a rock, for a bit of a backstory, Mrs. Porsha Princess Williams, age 39, who was a current cast member of The Real Housewives of Atlanta, most recently broke the internet and dropped a few hydrogen bombs when she revealed on her Instagram that she is currently madly in love and is currently engaged and is possibly pregnant with child to Mr. Simon Guabadia, who is her ex-fiance's business partner and is currently the soon-to-be ex-husband of Mrs. Faylene Guabadia, who is an associate castmate and co-worker of The Real Housewives of Atlanta franchise. Now, Faylene, age 31, most recently announced that her and Simon were divorcing just a little over a month ago. And after Porsha's Instagram announcement and to much speculation, it has been confirmed by Faylene that although divorcing, that her and her husband are still legally and technically married. So Porsha Luther King, as it stands, is engaged to a still very much married man. Now, many fans and onlookers have labeled this entire hot mess as scandalous and distasteful and disrespectful and cringe and reeking of desperation and selfish and self-centered and trifling and tacky and out of pocket and, more importantly, reckless, insensitive, and ruthless. But from my observation, there are more than a few cautionary tales to unpack here, and there are more than a few life lessons to examine and discuss in this crazy trauma triangle. Now, many people are saying that this reality TV spectacle is a fake and orchestrated publicity stunt, and that all of this drama is a manufactured con game for a ratings grab. But quite honestly, only time will tell. But the scripted lies, no matter how many ways you slice it, are entertaining. And when it comes to the viewing public, negativity and he say, she say, and black dysfunction will always sell, even if these scripted narratives are totally made up of pure BS. Ladies, a fabricated lie will always taste better and sell better than the truth. Now, the storyline secured a goofy stunt may be good for securing that peach and may be good for a dehydrated post-pandemic bag, but the optics of this situation are clearly trashy and the public perception has been quite triggering as it has brought out a variety of thoughts, mixed feelings, and emotions with women. But what's important to take note of are the spectrum and variety of responses, as some women have been critical, are disappointed and disgusted, and then there are the women who are in full support of Porsha's actions, which is not surprising to me because when it comes to the so-called magical thinking of girl code, there is none. And some feathers will be ruffled and some women will have their panties in a bunch with this video, but there are some things that need to be said. So do not argue with me, argue with your liver. Now, I first want to discuss the very problematic low value man and troglodyte that is Mr. Simon. Now, Mr. Simon is a slug and a lowlife. And the reason why he isn't catching a lot of flack or smoke for being a married, engaged man is because all eyes are focused on the distraction and the ego stroke of his $40 million bag. And another reason is simply because women will always be harsher on other women because women hold men to a much lower standard than they do other women. But this man is a philanderer, is full of distortion and gaslighting, and he vibrates at a very low frequency and is not a high value catch in the least, as his arrogance and his narcissistic drip is off the charts. Now, I know that with Porsha, as many women, is looking for her prince in the form of a payday and a money grab. But there is this thing called character and integrity to keep in mind, because any man who is willing to dump his wife and his blended family of 8 children all to publicly announce getting married to a complete stranger while still being married, in my opinion, is a complete nut job and a head case. And from the looks of things, and because things are moving at light speed, Porsha is being love bombed by a narcissist, and in time, the mask of Mr. Simon will be dropped and his true toxic nature will be revealed, as narcissistic men are working with a completely different operating system and are always on the hunt for worship. And for many women, a big enough bag is more than enough reasons to play with fire. But ladies, keep in mind, please keep in mind, that men like Mr. Simon change women like they change underwear. And while many women will believe that they can outsmart a narcissist by beating him at his own game, they often do not even know that a wealthy narcissist already can see the $1,000 bills in a woman's eyes and will already be 2-3 steps ahead of you when it comes to getting more out of the situation than you ever will. Not to mention that dealing with a narcissist, which many women do not know, is a strong form of spiritual warfare. And the pain and the abandonment and the disaster energy that they bring to a woman's life is a pain that money will never be able to cure. Now, just because a man gets on camera and says that his wife cheated on him does not make it the truth. And a capping narcissistic man will always lie and project when he is actually the guilty one. For anyone who's ever been with a narcissist, narcissistic men are always the victim, and they will humiliate you, disgrace you, and will discard you, and are disloyal down to the bone gristle. And they are men who will make you wish that you never ever met them. So ladies, let me know down below if marrying for a bag is worth destroying your mental and your spiritual health. Now on to the observations and on to the lessons. Number one, never confuse a honeymoon period with actual true love. True love is what happens when the honeymoon phase is over and the representatives of both the man and the woman drops their mask. As we all know that both men and women are inclined to show their best sides until time forces everyone to reveal their true heart and character. Only then can true love be determined. Anything before that is often confused with lust, chemistry, or a full-out con game. Number two, hypergamy is not about being cutthroat or about getting the bag at whatever cost. All money isn't good money, and when you blindly chase the bag and the bag alone, it will often come with dire consequences. Hypergamy is how women are naturally wired, but it isn't about hurting others or being an aggressive or desperate opportunist to do so. Number three, any man who changes women like underwear or who proposes to a woman while still married is a man of low character, who is not only being spiteful and vindictive, but he is also a man who has a low opinion of women, as that is a man who considers all women as disposable and throwaway. So in other words, with these kinds of men, ladies, you aren't special. It just happens to be your turn. Number four, notice how nonchalant and apathetic that Porsha's baby daddy, Dennis the Menace, is being about this entire situation. What man would show all 32 of his teeth to a man who just freshly left his marriage to marry his baby mama out of the blue? Dennis, in the absence of his masculine instincts, along with his willingness to throw caution to the wind by openly smoking a cigar in celebration with Simon, tells me a few things. That one, Dennis never had any intention on marrying Porsha, and two, that he is simply a man who is relieved that Porsha will now become another man's headache and is no longer his problem. And as a woman who gave a child to a man, that kind of public surrender, although Porsha won't admit it, has got to be a devastating blow to her ego, which could deeper explain Porsha's rebound energy and why she is jumping into this rushed marriage proposal and wholesale ignoring all of the giant red flags. Number five, a high-value man is not a man with money. Just to be clear, I have never conflated a man with having money with being high value. A high-value man is a man of integrity and high character who fully provides for his wife and children. Ladies, a high-value man is a man who is accountable, responsible, caring, and is mature in his masculine. So yes, a man having millions can be low value and can absolutely be a complete nightmare in a woman's life. And if you think that money doesn't come with crazy, just watch the throwback movie Sleeping with the Enemy. Number six, recognize when a man is trying to use you as a pawn in his petty, childish revenge game called being a rebound. Like it or not, Porsha, where the money reside, Williams, is a rebound. Ladies, always recognize when a man is trying to use you to jerk another woman's chain. This tactic is often called triangulation, where a man will use another woman to position himself to be the coveted and desirable prize between two or more women. And it is a strategy that works on women who are blinded by the bag, who see men as the prize, and are women who are willing to cut each other's throats to compete for him. Number four, recognize a desperado woman when you see one. A desperado is a woman who doesn't have the experience, the self-awareness, or the self-esteem to protect her reputation, nor does she have the skills to examine her poor decision-making. Her head is usually caught up in a clouded mixture of low self-worth, low-grade depression, spiritual darkness, and wanting to be rescued. So she instead makes spur-of-the-moment irrational decisions that are fueled by rejection and rebellion, all in a desperate attempt to find the hope of love. Most women will be or have been a desperado, including myself, at one point or several times in her life, and will make unsound decisions that are based on her past failed relationships, her unresolved daddy issues, her mommy issues, her insecurities, her lack of self-love, self-worth, and her inability to see herself as the prize. Number three, the instigators. Instigators are the people who care about you the least, and they will always be the first in line to celebrate the darkness and the dysfunction in your life by bringing lighter fluid and matches to the party. And they will laugh at you and record you while you play in traffic, because your life and your poor decision-making is for their entertainment. But know the difference between when people are laughing at you and not with you. Porsha may be indulging in this negative attention now, but those same supporters who are egging you on to ruin your life will turn on you like a corner and disappear like a magic trick. People who egg you on to be wrong and strong will do it because they don't care about you. Number two, and a lot of women are not going to want to hear this, but there is no such thing as girl code. As I have always stated on my channel, that women are competitive and comparative in the realm of men, provision, and getting the bag. So girl code is a faulty umbrella term that is used to shame women into moving as one united homogenous front. And not only are women not homogenous, they couldn't be even if they tried. Life is about and will always be about self-preservation and opportunity. Black women, just like any other race of women, are not a monolithic group, nor are they one giant moving part. Girl code has always been a fallacy and a myth. Just ask your grandmother, your mother, your sisters, your cousins, and your aunties. Because women can have poisonous egos too. Women can be just as cutthroat, wicked, envious, covetous, ruthless, uncaring, and just as entitled as men. As not all women are loving, caring, kind, compassionate, thoughtful, considerate, or nurturing. Your women friends, just like men, are to be vetted and weeded out. And what women need to arm themselves with, instead of the falsehood that is girl code, is the spirit of discernment, which Porsha is seriously lacking right now. As the spirit of discernment is more about a woman having a strong relationship with her instincts, her intuition, and her womanhood. And number one, pride will always come before the fall, and karma is real and is a dish that is served ice cold. Any woman who is willing to openly pour salt and gunpowder on another woman's wounds without care or concern will have her day, because karma marks everything down. And when you play stupid games, you win stupid prizes. So Porsha may be laughing and not giving a fudge now, but she will be crying later, because you reap what you sow and karma has no expiration date. And the same way that you get a man will be how you lose him, because a man will always do to you what he did to the previous woman, and sometimes even worse, especially when you are a willing participant in the betrayal and or devastation of a woman's unhappiness. So what does Phelan, the soon-to-be ex-wife, need to do? What Phelan needs to do is to make her anger expensive and to mind the hypergamous business that pays her with poise and ladylike grace by ignoring both Porsha and Simon until they both wither on the vine and self-destruct. Because a man cannot be stolen, and if any woman can take your man, ladies, let her have him and his baggage. Phelan and Simon are not divorced, and Phelan has every right to bleed this pregnant, beer-bellied Oompa Loompa dry. And as for Porsha and her raw and blind ambition, ladies, never openly claim a married man's bag while it still belongs to another, as that is a simple Simon rookie move that can backfire and make you look like a clownette. So that is all that I have to say on this for now. Ladies and lurkers, do you believe that Porsha Luther King has destroyed her reputation for a storyline and a check? And who here thinks that this relationship will make it past Christmas? Sound off in the comment section below. And as always, stay tuned for more cautionary tales to come. And I will catch up with you ladies and lurkers in the next one.